opinion, out of that six, two people bought it.
Yes.
May I ask, what's the 15 degrees?
Oh, you tell me what she said.
Okay.
Oh, what's the 15 degrees? What's the significance of that 15 degrees to move from one form to the other?
15 degree shift with
shift,
the, with the circles.
Did you come about
yes.
that?
What about it?
And what's the significance of that?
What's the significance
degrees?
Of it?
Yeah. How did you come about the 15 degrees to move from one form to the other?
I don't know if I know the significance of 15 degrees, you know, compared to 17. But
okay.
I do know that that's what it took for me to shift these circles to make it into a circle. So what happens is when I shifted the 7 inside, I shifted it 15 degrees. And all of these outside circles, which are 12, went like this.
Did you try shifting it 11 degrees or 16 degrees?
Yeah.
You did try.
Yeah.
So
I shifted it to 30 degrees and went right back to a cube. So it goes from a cube to a sphere to a cube to a sphere every 15 degrees. And between is a transformation. There's nothing wrong with the transformation. You can, you know, I have a drawing I didn't bring, Yuko, I gave it to her, she wanted it, that shows the transition between the 11 and the 7 and the 6 and all that kind of stuff that's going on. And that, you see, the thing is that the modern meditation for people today in the modern age is that you're supposed to have a mandala, okay, that isn't concrete anymore. It has to be moving, okay? So that's what this does. This mandala I've developed, it moved between the different degrees between a cube and a sphere, which is amazing that this happens. And so the idea is that you must be able to see the sphere and the cube at the same time. Now that's very difficult. You ought to be able to see a sphere and a cube at the same time. Not separate, not a circle and a square. You got to see them together at the same time. That's the modern new consciousness development meditation.
You see about the 15 degrees, if you can get back to Earth, Earth rotates 15 degrees every hour, 15 times 24 is 360 degrees.
Oh, I like it. I'll take it. No, I mean, you know what I mean? There's so much that we can get from all of this. I mean, that, you know, what you just said is, this changes everything.
Would you say it's a cure to cancer?
What's a cure?
A cure, not, you know, a road, a way.
Uh-huh. This is what you need. You need a will.
Wow.
You need a willpower to do this.
Wow.
To beat cancer, you need a will. A form certainly is an etheric form. It has a healing. There's no question about this. It's a healing form. When I first started in sculpture, when I was young, my degree was in sculpture, I always wanted to make a healing sculpture because many of these sculptures that I used to see in these plazas, they're sick. And when you walk into some buildings, you can become sick in these buildings. And I knew that because of the way I felt about it. And that's what I wanted to make healing sculpture. I never thought it would come like this. This is healing. Well, it's not going to heal cancer. I don't know. Maybe this did it, you know. Or maybe I did it. I don't know. But I think it's basically the will. You have to have a strong will. And you have to be very positive. You can't think negative thoughts. Okay? Yeah, I can't think of what the worst. Yeah. But you can't just think of the best either, because you have to get down to work. If you think everything, it's okay, I'll go away, they'll help me up there. No, no, come on, you've got to help yourself.
It reminds me of fluidity, it's just fluidity.
What, this one?
Like going with the flow. You know?
Well, that's what it does. And what's so amazing about it does it through straight and curved lines.
What's the form that goes like this in 360 degrees?
It's called, a lot of people call them a donut. But it's an inversion.
Yes. Yeah. When you had this on the...
You want it the other way?
Yes, please, because I feel like it's going to rock off.
But when you
well,
have...
Well, if it goes over, it's not mine. The owner's right over there. Well. She gave me a bad look. Stink eye. Okay,
it
so what you,
me
do you like it the other way?
Yeah, if you it's put it this way. And
it's
now,
heavy.
It's heavy, I can see that. And now, if it spins like you spun the... Yeah, I mean, carefully. But it has that same...
Oh, yeah, I put this into wire form and spun it.
Wow.
Like
wow.
The belt? No?
Yeah. That's just amazing. It's
beautiful.
Just amazing.
I wanted to add, it also has an energy of peace. Just everything about it, you know, peace. In fact, I would bet you that I could find every Hebrew letter in there.
You want another prize?
There is no prize.
It also the negative form also suggests that if you were to finish it, it would be a sphere. Do you see what the negative form?
Yeah, there is a negative form. This is not the Vesica. No, the Vesica Pisces. You know, it's, the Vesica Pisces is whiter. But it's what do you think, Dean?
I'm impressed.
But Dean had never seen it.
It almost feels like a key. Like it should be inserted. Like if you inserted that into something, something would happen.
It's definitely something out of science fiction.
It what?
It's like a science fiction thing. Something I would have saw on somebody else's artistic, you know.
Yeah, I missed it when I went out of the house. There was something about it, you know. I mean, even if I didn't make it, I still have something. I mean, nothing like it on the planet. Nothing ever like it. Think of all those years I've been doing geometry. It's amazing. Remember that even that cross, the sun cross, is in here. It's 19 circles.
Did you make it first in clay?
What's that?
Did you make it first in clay and then bronze it?
No, I made it first out of wood. I have the original one. Then I make these. I make these in such a way that I can take them to the foundry and they can burn them out. Not really based on I make all these things. I make these out of a construction board, and then I have a process of burning them out. And so every one of these things are different. Well, they're not different, but they're different sizes. Same with the Venus. Matter of fact, actually, this was made in Philippines. I've been able to actually do this after cancer. I didn't know how I was going to handle myself in a lecture. It's been hard. But I got through it. Also, Sebastian has all this work that he's done outside that you want to see, and there's refreshments over here that Cynthia and Stephen brought. So
and there's products too, books and jewelry and things.
Yes, and there's the jewelry. There's a different products that even we have taken the water. We have now pure heart water inputs, and it's been done with the device that I invented, and this one will have it in. Oh, there it is. There I am. Mixing the water right there, and this is really potent. It doesn't have this allows the life force to enter it, but not in a magnetic way. There's no magnets used in this. There's no magnets, there's no electricity. Okay? It's nothing but a form moving through water that implodes. Because this is all about implosion water here. This is implosion. The chest of Hadron is an implosion device. That means that the energy goes into the center and can't get any out any further and then expands to the outside and it's back in. And you'll see that on the implosion devices outside there. You'll see that the vortex goes in and it goes out and it disperses and it comes around and it goes back in. And you'll hear an implosion. It goes. That is the noise of implosion and it's never been heard before on Earth before, that implosion water. Oh, this is another product we did. We have the jewelry, we have the meditation chamber, we have the CEO working in the nurseries, and Sebastian, I think, and Stephen are going to go to a biodynamic conference in, I think, February or March. I can't remember when it is. Okay, and taking these devices, because these devices that, I don't know, Sebastian has done sap analysis of plants. And this, I think the thing that he said that was most important to me was that it allows the plant to do what it wants to do and more receptive to do what it wants to do than anything else, than before, than if you do nothing. Am I right, Sebastian, something like that?
Yeah.
Maybe you can tell a bit better.
Yeah.
What it does.
Well, it seemed like the life force that comes to the plant, it's become like more intelligent, if I could put it. It can pick in the soil what it needs really to be its healthiness. So it's very interesting. Even if we've seen research where the plants like have too much sodium coming into the soil, so the salt will create burned tips of the leaf. But if the plant receives enough biology and enlivening, it's able to actually protect itself from the harmful stuff in the soil. And then we've seen the level of sodium going down in the sap. So even chemically, we can see that the plant, through its vitality, is able to fight the harmful and really get its, what it needs to be healthy and strong against bugs and make its path here. So we're seeing that again and again, that the plant, when it's healthy, can protect itself from the soil. So there's a certain, it's able to perceive better what it needs and what's dangerous for it and pick out of the soil and bring it to it and produce more sugars that enlivens the soil biology and makes available then the nutrients for the plant to be strong and helpful. So there's higher production of sugars when the plant actually has the life forces they need. And the CBO with the water has been consistent. I've done carrots, broccolis, leaf, cabbages, many crops to see a different aspect, and on all levels, the plants are responding in that same way of being fuller, tastier, and even on the chemical analysis showing that they have more nutrients in them. So we want to pursue some more how it can help.
You know, I wonder if it's recognizing its archetype and gaining strength. Right.
That can't help it.
By what you're working on.
It's in it. That's part of it.
Right.
Absolutely part of it. And I think also that the CBO, when it mixes in the water, the pH goes up too, doesn't it? The pH, doesn't it change the pH too?
The pH seems to be pretty consistent. Didn't change so much the pH.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what about the iron content?
Yeah, the beginning research showed that some of the elements, like iron and manganese, were tending to transform. So there's when it's hard water, it actually softens it quite a bit.
Yeah, pretty neat. Okay, well, welcome, and you know, enjoy it, and thank you for coming. It made me feel a lot better.